Mr. Cole.
Saying, hey, I'm cool. I ain't playing with that bitch.
Hey, what's up, bro? Bro, thank you for taking time out to talk to me, man.
Oh, shit, that gonna help me too, fuck. I gotta stay out there, huh? Shit.
Hey, man, you ain't gonna never go nowhere, man. You a legend.
Oh, man, thank you, man. But shit, with outlets like this, I'll stay around, you know what I'm talking about? For real.
Oh, hey, man.
And why you think so many of them don't respond to that shit? Because, you know, they too much for it. How you too much to help your fucking self? You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
This shouldn't even be no thing. You know what I'm talking about? It should be like, shit, you should have relationships with everybody, really. You know what I'm talking about? That's serious about what they're doing.
Hey, exactly. You know what, man? You well deserve it, even without that being said, man, because you put out the hard work, the nice music, man, so it's well deserved on both ends, and I guess.
Exactly. That's why I can appreciate it. You know what I'm saying? Thank you, man.
Exactly.
For real.
So how's life, man? How's everything going?
Man, it's good, bro. I wish I would try to fix my mouth to complain. I can't. I'm overblessed, but my little cup running over, and I don't have shit. You know what I'm saying? My fucking cup running over, bro, for real, because it don't take all that, man. It don't take a lot. You know, to have a lot. It depends on what you have. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, what you do with it.
It's that too. That too.
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about? I'd rather have a little real shit than a whole bunch of bullshit. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, you know, everybody going broke trying to get that Rafe.
Fake it till you make it. Fake it till you make it.
Hey, well, you know, other than us being a magazine and a blog company, man, I personally am a fan of yours, man. So I follow your gram and I see you still touring and doing shows, man.
For real, man. For real. That's basically where it's at. Now, I've been recording too. I actually have, man, I got a body of music that's so incredible, but I don't know if it's incredible for the time for what's going on right now. And, you know, the answer to that is motherfucking right it is. It has to be packaged and presented in the right way. You know, I can't just put it out there because the, you know, all the other shit gonna suck it up. They gonna act like they don't even see it.
Well, let me ask you this, Mr. Cool. Is it Mr. Cool and KL, or is it Mr. Cool and a few people?
Me and a few people. KL got, you know, KL gonna keep the meat and potatoes. He gonna give me the backbone. He the skeleton. You know
right,
what I'm talking about?
Right.
Yeah. So I added the flesh and the eyeballs. You know what I'm saying? I ain't got no hair, so I let the bitch grow a beard. You know what I'm talking about?
Right.
Yeah. It's like incredible, bro. For real. That's how I've been surviving, because I could perform that shit to myself at home, and it just made me feel so good. It's inspiring. You know what I'm talking about?
Exactly.
I still have fun doing that shit. You know, I cannot wait till I can deliver that shit to y'all.
Hey, so for the people that don't know, man, is Mystical independent, or are we signed?
No, I'm independent. The last signing was the Cash Money thing, and that helped me in a lot of ways. You know what I'm talking about?
Right.
It helped me in a lot of ways. Not, I don't know about musically, but it helped me financially, and it helped me to, you know, to kind of get a grasp of what the fuck was going on. I still was kind of fresh from coming home from jail. You know what I'm talking about?
Right.
When I did that. You know, I came home in 2010, and I signed with them in 12. So my eyes were still a little, you know, a little fuzzy. I couldn't really see, you know, who I was talking to.
Okay, so everybody hear that, right? Give 1 point to Birdman.
You got to, man.
Exactly. You know what? With so much bad stuff being said about my man, for you to say something positive, like I said, all bullshit aside, we got to give that credit to Birdman.
What the fuck else can I tell that man but thank you?
Exactly.
For real.
Exactly.
Man, thank you, man. It's like, for real, real, real.
So, basically, you guys' current relationship is still good, right?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
And what's up with you and your boy, Master P?
Yeah, we just did a really, really big event in the city, man, in New Orleans at the Essence Fest. The No Limit reunion, that shit was incredible. For
wow.
Real.
Okay. It was lit, huh?
What, man, that shit had too much power. All the real pieces was there, right? You know, and no disrespect or no knock to the new limit and all that. I'm talking about the core was there. You know what I'm talking about? I'm talking about all down to everybody, for real. Every fucking, but that's still alive and that's free. You know what I'm talking about?
Okay. Hey, so you being independent, what's the name of the company you with?
Big Truck Music. That's what I'm screaming. Big Truck Music right now.
Okay.
I have a few options. You know what I'm talking about, as far as deal wise, but I'm kind of keep it independent. But mm-hmm. I'm still need that big machine behind me too. You know what I'm talking
definitely,
about?
Definitely. So is it Mystical?
That shit be. It'll work me too hard trying to connect this city to that city. I'm a hype extend my shoulder. I'm gonna tell my rotor cuff.
That's right. So is Big Truck just Mystical, or is it Mystical and a partner?
That's me. That's all I mean. And I have a few artists under it. You know what I'm talking about? Gifted artists. Not just no any motherfuckers. I ain't finna waste my time.
Well, let me ask you.
You know, it takes a lot to develop artists. You gotta deal with all this shit and everything. You know what I'm talking about? So the ones I got is definitely worth it. Gifted.
Right. And I was gonna ask you that question too. I'm gonna get on that real soon. Hey, but so with all the streaming doing as good as it doing, man, and everybody signing these exclusives, well, actually, they're trying to stop that. But I'm gonna ask you, like, do you feel like, you know, that's the best way to go now?
It depends. You know, what's good for me may not be good for you.
Right.
You know, but I sound like a good idea to me. You know what I'm talking about? Especially if you ain't got no fucking fans and they take you up to having fans. You know what I'm talking about? That should be a no-brainer.
Well, Apple, Tidal, where the check at? My boy, Miss Khalid, that.
Man, they know. Man, cut it out. No, I don't do all that. I done that shit already. You may see me. I ain't out here that. Nope. You know they can't. The motherfuckers can't tell me I ain't cold. Come on, bro. Because I still have to show up and do the concerts. We'll fuck around and have ciphers. I'm going to get the rap somewhere. So,
yeah.
I don't give a fuck how much you on the radio or how much you got in the bank. Come on now. Come on with them bars.
Exactly. You definitely got that.
Entertain me. Yeah. It ain't just about your fucking assets, you know. It's about what you bring to the fucking table.
Exactly. Hey, Mr. Let me ask you this, man. You got so many hits out there. What is your biggest hit today?
Shake Your Ass.
Shake Your Ass.
Without a doubt. Hands down. That bitch took me. I made laps around this little planet. For real.
Hey, man, that was crazy, Mr. Like, man, you was tight even before then, but that definitely was like, wow, where did that come
from?
For
real, that shit was crazy. That shit debuted number one on the pop charts, bro. I did like real laps around this motherfucker. That's when the world was still around. I don't know, they said it's flat now. This bitch could be a spinner top. Come on with the money, man.
Hey, you know what was so cool about it, in my opinion, man? You had already came with your own style, your own flow, your own type of music, which I respect. That's why I call you a legend. I just don't call you a legend because we're doing an interview. That's how I even feel, because, you know, it's very few of you guys, like you, E40 stepping the game with his own unique thing, and there's nobody like him, there's nobody like you. There's others, too.
And it's like we underdogs, like kind of like, not for real. If you ask E40 that, you know, I know him feel like no fucking underdog, because I know I surely don't. But, they, you know, the world looking at like we not where we should be. We don't have the thing that we deserve. Like I said earlier, my little cup running over. You know, now that I'm older, I don't need all them fucking cars and all that shit. My shit straight, man. Right. I got a nice fucking house. I don't live in the fucking apartment. You know, I have a home. You know, I have more than one vehicle. You know what I'm talking about? For real, well, man. My fucking kids have everything they want.
Right.
So, you know, I tell my fans, man, I'm straight. I would love to get back out there and make that splash, but it seems like you have to be a certain way to win in the industry. Now I go get me a job at the airport.
That's right.
For real,
that's right.
I ain't trying to be funny, and I swear I'm not knocking nobody, because I like a lot of the music that's out there. You know,
yeah. But you know what though? A lot of it sounds too much the same, and that's the problem. Like, you know, I'm not gonna say no names during the interview I'm doing with you, but
no, you don't have to. That says it all.
Yeah,
you know, and I really hate to say that, because that shit sounds so old fashioned. Like, maybe you just hate, you know, and that's not the case.
It's not.
You know what I'm saying? Because when we can come on, I can't help my fucking self. Like, where, man? I fuck with Future. You know what I'm talking about? A lot of a lot of motherfuckers, man.
Right, but you know what though? That what made music what it was, especially in rap, was the uniqueness. Everybody had their own style. So
thank you.
When you went to go buy the music, you knew exactly what you was going to get. You know,
that's what I miss.
It gets so bad to where, like I said, I was discussing with my partner the other day that somebody has a song out, I'm not going to say who, but they copied the same style of the other celebrity that was on that track. And it's like, it's like when you do a feature, you're supposed to still come with your flow, your style.
No, fuck no. Ain't nobody trying to hear that. Nobody, man, nobody ain't trying. Yeah, never sell nothing. You know, I got to try to do like, you know, I got to make my shit sound just like them, you know.
Yeah.
I gotta do that shit. I gotta make bigger. You know, I gotta try to sound like what's working. You know what I'm saying? I don't count Future in that, because Future was the one that started.
Yeah,
the shit that come after that, nigga, you ain't Future. I already listen to Future. I already listen to the real one. You know what I'm talking about? Shit, man. They got a lot of fucking good artists. Drake, now what the fuck can you fix your mouth to say about Drake?
Right.
I don't know what you can say about a character. I'm talking about as far as making records. Yeah, I get it. Fuck, man. It's fucking props.
Hey, if you don't, you're a hater, man, whether you like it or or not at the end of the
day. Man, I don't give a fuck how you feel. See you dancing off that fucking beat. It's going to be hard not to. That nigga should jam, man. You know, you got to give Wayne his props for bringing a motherfucker like him and Nicki. When I came home, I said, God damn, Nicki Minaj rapping better than a lot of these niggas out here. Fuck that girl. Right. I flow. You know what I'm saying? This motherfucker be spitting.
You know what, man? I like Nicki. I love Nicki. Don't get me wrong. And she's still one of the hottest in the game. You can't take nothing away from that boss lady. But, you know, when you say something like maybe Remy won that little personal beef, the little hat, you know what I'm saying? People take it as you don't like Nicki, and that's not the case.
That's not. You. That's Remy gave motherfuckers something we was missing. We was missing that a little bit, weren't we? Yeah. We was missing that, bro. She can't deliver that bitch like hot pizza. She had the dough thing in your mouth. Homie, what is it? That's Remy with that fucking heat. Oh, Lord. Man. You know, so, man, you can't explain no better than that. Yeah. That shit is good. Let me tell you something, bro. Talent will never go out of style. Exactly. I don't give a fuck when you come with it. you know what I'm saying?
And it takes nothing away from Nicki. Nicki is still one of the baddest in the game. But at the end of the day, if two people was on a racetrack and they race, regardless of who you like, a win is a win.
Right.
You know,
it
still doesn't take them away from nobody else.
Mm-hmm. Now, having said that, as who I want to hear, I want to listen to Nicki Minaj. I want to look at Nicki Minaj. You know what I'm saying? It's, you know, so
yeah,
you know, we
definitely.
Don't have our preferences. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah,
now, Remy shit, when I want to hear some fucking balls and some other, you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah,
because she raw in her because she had to work hard in her, you know.
You know, the only thing I wanted out of that, Mr. Cool Man, I ain't going to spend too much time on it. What I wanted was, I wanted Nicki to come direct like Remy did. You know what I'm saying? I wanted her to somehow have.
She's too rich, too successful.
No, but the thing was, the song was so big and it had so much of an impact to where if you don't respond, you got to do it right. That's all I'm saying.
Right.
If you ain't, like Miss Squire, I heard you say before.
Yeah,
so,
you ain't gonna do it right, don't
so,
do it at all.
So
right.
If Nicki could have came like directly, like if somehow she had information about Remy that we didn't know about, or
in Nicki defense, who the fuck Nicki got something to prove to?
Nobody.
So you gotta kind of look at her perspective too. And you absolutely right what you said, and I definitely agree with you. You motherfucking right. You know what I'm saying? Because look at the results of it.
Yeah. My thing is,
dolls all broke to pieces. Y'all trying to fuck over my baby.
Hey, if you're not gonna do it, then don't do it at all. Like if you feel like you that big, I'm not gonna say nothing, I'm not gonna touch it. But if you don't decide to say something, you gotta come with that same force she came with.
Smoke. Yeah, you supposed to knock fire from her motherfucking ass.
Yeah,
for real.
Hey, and listen to some of Nicki music. I know she
and you know what? I'd have took my time. I wouldn't have came right back with a hole. Y'all finna let me get this. Because I ain't no telling how long. We don't know how long Remy Ma worked on that motherfucker.
Yeah,
you know what
exactly.
I'm talking about? We didn't hear it until it was right. You know what I'm saying? That's just like when I first put my foot through the rap, though, it was hard. Because them niggas had, you know, I'm coming from New Orleans. Them niggas from New York and California, the big, you know, they got the money. So I couldn't come. I had to come all the way.
Right.
You know, because I ain't going to have nothing but this talent. You gonna love me or hate me, motherfucker. I ain't know he all right. Nah.
Hey,
that nigga cool.
Mystical.
You just ain't gonna understand, maybe like, oh, that shit wacky. You know what I'm saying?
It's not a lot that we see in your personal life, and I wanna ask you something, not personal, but let me ask you this.
I'm 6 years old.
That's right. Hey, in the No Limit days, which was probably some of your better times, we could say, how was life? Like how was Mystical living? As far as like the flashy money, like was you living how the videos were showing, or was
yeah,
that just
well, listen, image? listen. We were, you know, they ain't have it wasn't studio gangsters wasn't really out yet. Like talking about it, we used doing the real. We ain't know how to do the fake shit yet. But you know that's where the fake shit come in because we trying to emulate those days. So like sometimes it be good and then. That's, you know, you hit the lottery, what you ain't hit number $1 million, that shit gonna go how you spending. You know what I'm talking about? So after the money gone, you still be trying to hold on to that fucking feeling. And that's what a lot of these youngsters doing. You know, drug dealers want to be rappers and rappers want to be drug dealers. We gotta make our fucking mind up.
Right,
you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Yeah, I'm a rapper, but I'm a drug dealer. I got the drug dealer persona. You know what I'm talking about? Mm-hmm. About that we were trying to get the fuck out of. You know what I'm saying? But that, it ain't that. It's drug dealer 9 times out of 10. A real ass nigga.
You know what's crazy? Most drug dealers and real gangsters, they didn't want to be known because they knew the consequences.
Back in those,
they,
yes.
knew, They knew the consequences of getting caught. You know what I'm saying?
Thank you. You see, it's a different seriousness. Yeah. And I ain't coming for no foolishness. The stakes are higher. You know what I'm talking about? Motherfuckers playing for keeps on that level. So it's almost going to be impossible for you to be a bitch-ass nigga. You're going to get killed, bro. Somebody going to kill you.
Hey, man. I watch some of these celebrities, man, and they go straight to their Instagram like, nigga, I'm going to smoke you. I'm like, huh? Like, what? Nigga, did you just say that?
For real, real life, out your mouth. That's supposed to be grounds. I have authority right now to fuck you up. I must thrash you. I got to. But then I'll take no threat like that lightly. You know what I'm talking about? You could be whoever you, whatever the fuck you want to now. Mm-hmm. You know? Yeah, that was crazy.
Let me get back to you, Mystical, man. Hey, now, I know you said Shake That Ass was one of your biggest hits to today.
No. The biggest. Period.
Oh, the biggest. Okay.
Yeah, that one took me to the pop world.
Is that the same thing as far as when you perform it, though? Like, when you perform it, is that the one that erupts the stadium, or is it another one?
I gotta say that one last. That one kind of little more nostalgic, and it's a little more burnt. I think that one get a harder hit when I do it live, right, with the band. Now listen, in my regular show, when that bitch come on, the initials hearing of it, right, that bitch get a roar.
Oh yeah, you know it.
But it ain't fucking with. Here I go. Just get out the way. It ain't fucking with them. Nah, it ain't fucking with them. It ain't fucking with my anthems, for real.
I missed
that. Was a hit. That wasn't no anthem. You know, the anthems is for the streets. A hit for the world. Yeah. That was my hit. You know what I'm talking about?
I remember the first time I ever heard some of your music, man. Now, excuse me, I don't mean to sound disrespectful if I am, but...
No, man, keep it real. Come on,
man. Hey, look, the man right there, that was my shit.
How crazy that was? You had to kind of apologize before you gave me a compliment, because nowadays, if I try to see you something good, I'm on your dick now. Ah, man. Man, so many dudes being lying, taking pictures with me. I wish a nigga would call one of them fucking dudes a groupie. Boy, hello. Cause you ripping me now, you ain't even fucking with that man. You trying to use me to fuck over him. You know, that's crazy, bro. You have to apologize for you getting that compliment. And I do that too. I'd be like, man, no disrespect. Cause, you know what I'm talking about? It's so phony.
You know why I say that, Mystical? Cause I'm pretty sure you got a lot of good music probably even before then. But unfortunately, right, that's when I took notice of you. And from there, I've been a fan ever since. Like, my mom.
Oh, okay, from that perspective, yeah. But, man, what, man? Anyone you like, I don't give a fuck about the last one. You know what I'm saying? All my fans didn't come on from the beginning. You know what I'm saying? I gained a lot of fans from Shake Ass. Mm-hmm. You know, I ain't the motherfucker that didn't really know who I was. You know what I'm saying? Till Shake Ass. Because that took me to the world. You know what I'm talking about? So, I mean, I'm grateful, man. I'm grateful. That's why I ain't even talking about, man, you take pictures with everybody? Man, I'm 46 years old. Motherfucker still won't take a picture with me. Jeez.
I definitely appreciate it, man.
Man, real, recognize real, bro. You deserve this. You earned this. I don't even know you. But if I'm here, I know this is where the fuck I was supposed to be at. So, you know what I'm talking about?
Now, Mystical.
For real, you got to get take your credit too, pimp. Believe that. You did something right. Fuck. For real. And I'm prepared to do this interview. Nigga, that was too easy. Nigga, I need to do an interview. Okay. You got a number. Call me. Right. Now we on the phone. From social media, my nigga. Social media.
You got to do it however you can do it, man. You got to get it done, man.
The fuck social media is for. That's what outlet is for.
Hey,
for us to do business. Not for me to beef with you, nigga. I'ma catch it. Pull up, nigga, pull up.
Niggas don't know about me, though. I graduated from college at a late age, 28. As an engineer, I can mix, I can master, I can do it all. The thing was, like, they sell you the dream that when you get out, you know, you're going to have a job waiting for you. But I was thinking independent the whole way anyway, so.
Right. You know, right. That's the grind way, too. That's the grind. That way you can appreciate it better. And another thing, that's why this fucking interview is so cold, because you got a background in it. You know, you can tell the difference between somebody interviewing somebody you don't know shit about. Man, I don't do them interviews. All right, miss. Bitch, you don't even know who I am. Why am I talking to you? You know what I'm saying? You can't bring the people nothing if you don't know what the fuck you're talking about. All that shit makes a difference, bro. It was a good-ass interview. That's real talk. Hey. I do all kind of interviews.
And I appreciate it.
All kind of platforms. It's just as good as all the rest of the motherfuckers.
Hey, man, my mom is no longer here, but she was definitely a fan of yours before she left.
Sorry about that.
It's all good, my nigga, but she definitely was a fan of yours, and she'd be proud to know I even had this conversation with you, man.
Wow, bro.
You know, thank you, man. You helped me out, man, because through me, she can now experience, you know, a talk with one of her favorite artists.
Wow, Now it makes sense to you. Now you see why I'm on this motherfucking phone? You see what I'm talking about?
Hey, God is good, man.
That's, man, all the time, bro.